Irwin. I'm a counselor in the high school at Sacred Heart, and I just wanted to touch base with our community and so many of you and just
kind of checking in.
I think this time with COVID and isolation, us having to quarantine, creates feelings of isolation. And there's so many emotions that we're all feeling right now. You know, I know that for myself, I've had feelings of, you know, I've been anxious and stressed. I've also struggled with motivation, sadness, anger, all of these things combined. And at different times, it goes up and down. So I imagine many of you have felt similar things. And it can be tough. So I would definitely suggest that when it comes down to it, it's self-care. That we truly need to be able to take care of ourselves and prioritize that, especially when we start to notice our, you know, emotions heightened in different ways. And there needs to be some healthy ways of coping. One thing that I think that I found more than anything, and I'm sure many of you too, is exercise. I did not have the flexibility to exercise as much before this, so it's been a positive for me, but I exercise one way or another every day, and it truly makes all the difference as far as how I'm feeling and takes a lot of the pressure off. I think it's also very important to connect with others, and right now that is different than we're used to doing, but there are still ways to connect. And making sure that you have, you know, sounding boards, someone that you can talk to, someone that's going to listen, someone that's going to help you kind of put it in perspective. And to, you know, kind of say, okay, you know, maybe we need to take it down a notch. I think it's all important. It's important that we all have someone like that in our lives. It's so we have exercise, we have, you know, making sure that we connect with someone to be able to listen to us during this time. I also think that it's really important that we are able to try to create some sort of structure or routine. It's going to be different. It's not going to be the exact same, but it truly does kind of keep us moving and going forward and create somewhat, you know, a safety net and us feeling a little better as things are going on. It's really understandable right now that I would imagine that our, you know, our seniors and our senior parents, more than anything, are feeling not just, you know, stress and anxiety, but feelings of loss. You know, the seniors in our community and in every community around the country and the world, you know, there were certain things that they've always looked forward to having in a certain way. And will we still have those? Many of those, I hope so. But it's not the date they thought it was going to be. And they haven't been there to kind of end their year and have that closure. And that's, you know, that's a huge loss. And that can be very hard to go through. I think that the only thing you can do, nobody can fix that. You know, there are definitely different ways we can work together to try to make it better. But what we can do is try to put it in perspective to a certain extent. Like, let's see in our community how maybe you can help others. I ran into somebody today that was saying that, you know, she thought that maybe that would be a great idea, and it is such a great idea that when you're able to help others, it makes you feel good. It also gets you kind of see the bigger picture and outside of yourself and kind of realize, okay, you know, yes, this isn't fun, and I do deserve to have these different feelings about what I'm going through, but at the same time, there are things that could be worse. So gaining that perspective, you know, it's also important to
just kind of, you know,
understand that we're in this for the long haul, but it will get better. It's going to, and that we're doing this because we need to for our own well-being. So please don't hesitate to reach out to me if there's anything you need, anything that I can do to help, at all moving forward. But just know that I'm thinking about you, and, I'm feeling probably a lot of the same things that you're feeling right now. And I'm not saying it's always easy to deal with, but, I hope that you're find some, maybe some good tips or something that you can do moving
forward. Thanks so much.